accurate meteorologist using the only live Doppler radar. Live Super Doppler HD, keeping you safe under an umbrella of protection.
Welcome back, everyone. Well, today, a little tough out there at times with an inch of snow on the ground, a little slippery, but the streets in pretty good shape by late in the day. Now the problem is with the fresh snow, the temperatures are going to plummet. We've had to revise things downward for tonight, and you can see the general trend, mid-teens by 9 p.m., low teens, and by 7 a.m., around 4 above zero. All right, cold temperatures already. Again, this stripe up here, Mason City, Fort Dodge, Rockwell City, that is the area of heavier snowpack from the last system. And the temperatures today struggled, single digits. Now, just imagine what will happen now that the sun is down, clearing skies, light winds. This entire region of the state will be well below zero. Single digits for the rest of us, at least for tonight. You can see the clearing trend now across state. No clouds to come in to stop the heat from radiating back out into space. High temperatures today struggle to the north of us, 17 Minneapolis and Bismarck, lower 20s around Omaha. But tomorrow we will see a change. High pressure starts to drift south, and as it does, our winds will allow to return back out of the southwest. Additionally, there will be some warmer air sliding into the western counties by late in the afternoon. So that change in the wind really won't help us early in the morning, but by noontime and early afternoon, it will be much better. Now, here's the forecast low temperatures, and there will be spots up in this purple shading across north central and into northwest Iowa. It will be around 7 or 8 below tonight, but you can see central Iowa onto the east, single digits, and below zero as you head north of 20 and onto the west of Interstate 35. All right, for Des Moines and central Iowa tonight, about 4 degrees, clear skies, light winds. Winds gradually shifting around tomorrow, out of the southwest, about 10 to 15, and that should be enough, even with a little snow on the ground, to get the temperature back up around the freezing point. Now, if we get a little melting during the day, then Sunday will be a little bit better than that, around 40 degrees, where you have the heavier snow, especially west-northwest, it will not be quite as nice. Monday, clouds, maybe a little drizzle, and then we're still talking about a pretty high probability of rain moving in late next week. That is going to come in the Wednesday, Thursday time period. You can see the temperatures here. It will be above freezing with the exception of a little bit early Wednesday morning. I think we'll see all rain moving in later Wednesday and continuing through the early morning hours of Thursday. As that system pulls out, then colder air replaces it with temperatures Friday and Saturday dropping back to around 30 degrees.
For tonight is probably going to be one of the coldest nights so far of the year, isn't it?
Probably the second coldest.
Yeah, yep. We've been pretty cold. If we can get through tonight, we'll be good. Thanks, Sean. Come